Fresh and Fit. I just started watching them a few weeks before the drama happened. I am honestly surprised that it took this long for someone to speak out against them. They streamed for 5 hours to clear up allegations against them. And yes, I watched those 5 hours, not once, but twice. And I took notes because I didn't want to miss a thing. In that stream, there was a lot of manipulation, hypocrisy, contradiction, and they're over here thinking they're clearing their name when in fact, they're giving us more footage and more evidence that they are phonies. I understand I'm a woman, so I know nothing about the manosphere. That ain't my type of scene, that ain't my community. The blue pill, the red pill, the black pill, all these pills, I don't care about it. What I care about is that this podcast is giving out toxic energy, and these guys are molding the brains of these young men to become emotionally and mentally abusive. This video here is just an introduction of what kind of channel this is. They promote their channel to be the number one male self-improvement podcast in the world. Or are they just trying to make money off of them? You decide. Now, what these guys do is they invite Instagram models. Most of these women are not debaters. They don't do their own research. Some of them don't even know what this podcast is really about. They're thinking they're going on this channel just to speak about their single life. When in fact, Fresh and Fit are there to humiliate them, to degrade them, to disrespect them, and to show men how to treat women. Before the podcast begins, they take away all their cell phones, which makes sense because you don't want distractions. But that is not the only reason. These women don't have access to the internet to do their own research as they're speaking on these topics. But Fresh and Fit do. They have their cell phones out and they have pen and paper to write notes. Before they start filming, they provide these women with alcohol. So some of these girls that are drinking are not even in their sober mind to debate, which makes them look dumber. And that is what these guys' intentions are to do, is to make them look dumb. They ask these women the same damn questions. Are you single? How tall do you want your man to be? And what's the minimum annual income you want them to have? A lot of these women don't care about their annual income, but they push them to answer that question because it's a trap. They're making them out to be gold diggers. And once they answer, they bombard them with a whole bunch of statistics backing their side. It's just crazy. And ladies, why are y'all going on there? Do your research. Look at their videos. Look how they treat these ladies. Y'all should not be going there. Because the second you're there, Myron is gonna kick your ass out. The second that you prove points, he loses it.
All right, you gotta go, man. You gotta go.
Oh my God.
You gotta go. You're wild.
Wait, why she gotta go? Why she gotta go? Why she gotta go?
You're already done. Get out. I'm dead ass. Get out. Take your headphones. Get out.
Let's take several seats, guys. It's okay.
Yeah, get her out of here. Get out of here. You're good. You're done. No, you're done. You're done. Okay. All right. Get up. Get out. Please get the fuck out. You guys have been wild and disrespectful, so just get out. People don't want you here no more. All right, yo, get the fuck out, man. Like, seriously, I'm done with this shit. Yo, get the fuck off the show, man.
Thank you.
All right, take off your headphones. Get up. Get the fuck out. All right, get the fuck out.
No problem.
Real talk. Get out.
All right, go ahead.
Appreciate you.
Get out.
All right. Ignorance.
I was way more short-tempered back then. I'd kick them out before the show if they annoyed me.
There was a girl that came right to the platform. We were downstairs in the lobby. Myron saw the girl, spoke to her on the spot. She didn't get an elevator. Leave. I was like, bro, we didn't even do the show yet.
Yeah.
So Frank Castle is real life, is real in life and on camera. This used to happen off camera all the time.
Yeah.
Like, dude, the girls are here. All are gone.
Myron does not know how to control his emotions. They're saying this as if it's something to be proud about. Kicking out these girls make you feel good? Is that what makes you more of a man? I don't understand that. Myron spends his time doing his research, his homework, his notes, looking up statistics and facts, and then he uses that information to manipulate the minds of these young men just to fit his interpretation on how society is and how it should be. There's a couple things that I do agree with, but most of it is trash.
Value man who just said he's dated multiple OnlyFans strippers.
I never referred to myself as a high value man, but okay.
You don't consider yourself that?
Yeah, you know, I don't want to be cocky, but I have dated multiple women that work in that industry.
I feel like you have the right to answer yes or no to these questions.
Yeah, are you a high-value man?
Are you a high-value man?
That'd be very cocky. Anyway.
Are you a high-value man or not? Yes or no?
Listen,
you know,
ladies.
Do you meet the criteria of a high-value man as per that Samuel's
man
on
YouTube? You guys can assume what you like.
The point I'm trying to make is... Why can't you answer it?
I think deflection is very telling.
Okay, well, you guys can assume...
So he's a wannabe high-value man?
There you go, wannabe.
You have no problem advertising yourself as a high-valued man on a sugar baby site. Trained to be alpha males when in fact they are not. Their actions don't fit it. And now that they were outed as phonies and frauds, they are now saying that they never claimed to be alphas.
Step out, guys. We are not naturals. I don't know why people think like we say we're alphas or we're natural. We never said that. We are nerds that figured this shit out, guys, and now we're teaching you!
So basically what you're saying is, you were not a natural alpha, but you learned to be an alpha. Either you are or you're not. That alone tells us that you're not. And you should not be teaching these young guys how to be one if you don't live it yourself. Y'all are scam artists. You guys are literally taking money from these guys to teach them a lifestyle that even you don't live. That's a scam. They both don't know how to communicate. One stutters and the other one speaks 1,000 words a minute and isn't great at listening. Now, if these guys want to teach these young men how to succeed in relationships, the number one thing that makes a relationship successful is communication. And these guys don't have that skill.
That's why, real talk, on this podcast, one of the most controversial things I say is if a girl doesn't have sex with you, you need to kick her to the curb. She's useless. And that's the truth.
That's what it is.
When you're dealing with a higher status man, he has the leverage and you got to get on his program because he is the prize, not the woman. So if you want commitment from a man, you need to understand and know your role. Men lead, women follow. Women want a man that is better than them. That is a fact.
They love to talk about statistics and what words mean because a lot of people misuse them, including himself.
What does misogyny mean? What does misogyny mean?
Misogyny, it's like, you know, being against women in general.
No, it is the hatred and or contempt of women.
Yes, thank
where
you
do
for
we
that
say we hate women?
Definition.
Please tell us where.
Where do we hate women?
Where?
Where do you hate women?
Yes.
Yeah. Is that the only definition of misogyny?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wrong. There is another definition. A person who dislikes, despises, or is strongly prejudiced against women. Sounds about right. But since you don't like that word, let's use another word. How about sexist? Characterized by or showing prejudice, stereotyping, or discrimination, typically against women on the basis of sex. Let me break it down for you guys a little bit more. What is discrimination? Unjust or prejudicial treatment of different categories of people or things, especially on the grounds of race, age, or sex. I mean, the proof is all there. Look at every single one of their videos, every single one of their posts. They are misogynists and sexists. You are leading these young followers into an unhealthy path. They might get the money, they might get the career, but it's going to be really hard for them to find a relationship. And that's due to your teachings. Guys, pay attention. Look at the women on the panel. Most of them do not agree with him. So my question to you guys is, are you trying to date women or are you trying to date men? Because from what it looks like, these ladies are pretty much telling you guys, no, that's not how you get me. Pay attention. There's video after video after video speaking against them. But they have friends. They say they have friends behind the scenes supporting them.
This whole ordeal has taught us who really has our back. And it's funny, man, a lot of big creators call us on the phone behind the scenes and say, yo, y'all got this, we support y'all.
Now, if they were really supportive, why is it behind the scenes? Why aren't most of them coming out and speaking on your defense? And now they're so desperate to prove to their followers that they still have support, that they're name dropping. Throughout the whole stream, they're name dropping. I lied to you, look.
Quick, I wanna make a quick little shout out to everyone. We just got off the phone, Mr. Organic.
Yeah.
Thank you to Mr. Organic. Thank you to Alpha Male fucking Strategist.
Yeah, AMS.
Car Reviews.
DJ Academics.
Yep. Jabrizi.
Saint
the Sinner. Donovan Sharp. John from Modern Life Dating. Rolo Tomasi. You know,
yeah.
Taking our side and looking at both sides of the coin, man. So thank you guys for at least giving us the chance, bro.
And now men from the Manosphere community is speaking out.
You have like 20,000 plus subscribers because all you've done is spread hate.
Yep.
That's all you've done is spread hate. So nothing positive is going to come from spreading hate and talking about other people.
Now, isn't that what you guys are doing? Your whole podcast spreads hate and negativity. You didn't think it was going to come back to you? Oh, wait, let me use your words. You're just an exception? That's not the rule? It's bad karma. It came back to bite you in the ass. And this is why your sub count has gone down. You went from 430,000 subscribers. You lost 45,000 subscribers, supporters, fans, whatever you want to call them. They were your following and you lost them because of your lies, manipulation, contradiction, and hypocrisy. But apparently you don't care that you lost subs.
Losing subscribers doesn't hurt the pockets.
Or do you? Because at the end of the stream, this is what you said.
Guys, like the video, subscribe back to us.
I'm just showing y'all what they're putting out there in their 5-hour stream. They did it to themselves. As we all found out, Myron used to work in law enforcement. He was a Homeland Security officer.
My name is Amber Fuddle. I was a former special agent of Homeland Security Investigations. I worked for the agency since 2010 as an intern. I did criminal investigations. I resigned from the job in 2020. I did cases against child pedophiles, terrorism cases. I did Mexican drug traffickers, human traffickers, human smugglers. Very stressful job. I've done wiretap cases where I've listened to phones for days on end. No sleep. So yeah, in my 20s, it was very stressful.
Now, I don't want to come off like I'm bashing them. I do want to have some understanding of why these guys are the way they are. Now, experiencing those things could have created PTSD, which explains a lot. That's probably why his behavior is the way it is.
So Dr. Freer, let's talk about some of the most common symptoms of PTSD.
You can kind of categorize them in four types. So the first is re-experiencing. You heard India talk about flashbacks, bad dreams. The second is avoidance. People who have PTSD tend to avoid things, places, even thoughts that might remind them of the traumatic event. The third is arousal and reactivity. Now, that really points to being easily startled or feeling on edge a lot, having difficulty sleeping, or having angry outbursts. And then last but not least is cognition or thinking and mood.
I don't know if he's ever gotten help for it, but before he can help other people, he should start helping himself. Go to therapy, get some treatment, take some medication. Because this is not how you treat people in general. All right, so this is just an introduction to you guys. I will be posting another video soon about the whole Abba and Preach situation and on the whole break-in with Allende. Listen, the proof is in the pudding. The footage is out. So we're gonna talk on it in the next video. Stay tuned. Make sure y'all like, comment, share, and subscribe. And please hit that bell so you can get notified every time I upload. See you in the next video. Peace.
Actions have consequences.